Okay, good evening. Good evening, everyone. And I hope you stayed inside and at 5 you expressed your gratitude towards all the people who have been, at the front end, bringing news, bringing medical help and all sorts of other help to you. And we are expecting a few more days of that lockdown, but I think it is for the benefit of us, so we should cooperate with the government. Now, again, as a part of my lecture too, average, today's concept is average versus total. To start with this concept, you might be wondering what I'm talking of, but and in the last class I told you that maths and economics are correlated with each other. So let us do a little bit of maths today. And now I have there are two classes here. In one class, I have 5 students, that is A, B, C, D, and E. And the other class, that is class B, I have 10 students. Right? Now, if I take a total, then obviously, if I compare, now these are the marks which are scored in economics. Here, let us assume that economics paper is of 100 marks. Now, if you see, child A scored 90, child B scored an 80, child C 90, child D 10, then E is got a 0, then of course F is also got a 0, and then we have 16, 19, 20, 0 and 10. And this is a pattern of scoring marks in economics in class B, whereas the marks scored by every individual in class A is 90, 16, 90, 80, 70. Without comparing the total or without looking at the average, which class do you think is scored a little better? Is it class A or class B?
Class A.
Why A? Because see, none of them are 0. All of them are in the first class or beyond that, that means 60% and above. Right? In class B, some of them have got good marks, but then we have people who are getting less marks also. Right? If I take total marks and I compare, forget about who's got how much, now I look at total marks. I will say that the total of class A is 390, whereas the total of class B is a massive 440. Which class is getting more marks?
B.
Once again, it is the B class. But is it right to compare this total? Can I say on the basis of total, the average performance of on the basis of total, the performance of class B is better than class A in economics? No. Why? Because there are people who have not got any marks, there are people who have got less than the passing percentage. Right? Now, this shows that total figure doesn't give you the accurate score of every individual. If I need to now forget about the marks, let us take it as income. Okay, let's see that all this is income expressed in thousands. So if I start, this is 90k, this is again 80k, 90k and then so on. 0k means you are not earning anything. Then again k and then k and then k, k and then k. You would be wondering that yeah, in an economy it is possible that there are people who are earning nothing. Yes, it is possible. You know, I'm not saying that people who are not earning anything are not contributing to the society. But yes, when they are not earning anything, they are just taking from the economy. They are not contributing to the economy. Now, whenever such a situation happens, we have a cash crunch. We have an economy crunch. See, what is happening? We are all sitting at home. We are not able to contribute. We are only taking from the economy. And that is why everybody is getting very jittery. And it is not on a personal level, on a micro level. It is at a national level, a macro level, and a world level, global level. Everybody is worried that what is going to happen in the next 20, 30 days or 1.5 months. Our contribution to the economy should also be made. Right? Now, a country which has more population, obviously will have more amount of total income. That means 440k. Now, a country which has lesser population, of course, will have lesser total income. But that would that mean that the earning of this particular country is population, we have more income. The country which has lesser population, we have lesser income. Now, to control and that to overcome this drawback of total income, we take average income as a criteria to compare various countries of the world and not the total income. Why? Because the country with more population will have more income and the country with lesser population will have lesser income. This is a very prominent question that they ask in boards. Right? And it's a common sense basically. So, again, instead of this, if we look at the number of people or population, there are 10 people here, so my average becomes 440 divided by 10. Matlab, agar isko hum, instead of marks, marks le to every individual is earning 44 marks. Aur agar isko income le to an average individual is earning 44k, a means 44,000. So, in any ways, it means that this country's performance is better than that country because there the average performance will be how much? Go home. It's the other way around. If we take the average here, it is 390 divided by the number of observations of number of people. So that means 5. Right? So now when I divide it by 5, 5 sevens are 35 chicken and 5 eights are 40. So I have 78k. Agar hum isko income ke saath compare kare, to 78,000 average earning hai per month. Country A में और country B में average earning है 44k. अगर हम इसको marks के basis पे लें तो again here also the marks earned are 44 marks out of 100 marks which an average individual is getting, and in class A we are getting 78 marks out of 100 marks which an average individual is getting. Now keeping this entire concept in mind, try and understand that per capita income is a better or an average observation is a better observation as compared to the total observation. So total observation, the number of observations are more, obviously the quantum of observation will be large. When number of observations are less, the quantum of observation will be less. That would not mean that the particular area or a country with lesser population is having lesser income. In fact, it is always the other way. Now, so this was the beginning of our lecture, that is average population or average income versus total income. So why do you think average income is a better criteria as compared to total income? Because the country with more population, obviously will have more income, but that would not mean that every individual is earning that income. But again, there is a problem in this kind of evaluation also. We come to know that this is the average earning, but we do not come to know about the dot bonds. There might be people who are not earning anything. There might be people who are very rich, but there might be few people who are very rich, but there might be so many people who are very, very poor. Right? So, this problem is there with average income also. Average income itself doesn't give you complete information about how much a country is earning. That is where Human Development Index also comes into question. Right? Now, there were two criteria of judging a country. One was given to us. United Nations Development Program, and the other one was given to us by World Bank. UNDP came up with three criteria, that is literacy rate, prevailing in a country at one particular point of time, then of course the life expectancy. Index is called as HDI. So how is HDI Fourth, it is formed after taking observation about the literacy rate, the life expectancy and per capita income of a country. On the basis of these readings, a ranking is created and 177 countries of the world are ranked. Right? Now, when we talk about World Bank criteria is very simple. World Bank uses only per capita income to classify various countries of the world. Right? So now, as per the criteria given by the World Bank, of course, I told you what is an average, what is a total income, what is an average income. Now, let us come down to the reports of World Bank. Now, the World Bank says that the country with per capita income of US$12,056 and above in 2017. Now, some of the old books will have the reading of 2030. Our new book, I think, has a reading of 2017. So, those countries which are rich countries must have an income of US dollars. Now, the countries with per capita income of 955 rupees or less are in low income category. So, low income category $1,820 yearly. Right? This was an average earning. अब इसमें भी कई लोग ऐसे होंगे जिनकी income बहुत high रहेगी जिसकी वजह से 1820 चला गया है. अगर उनको निकाल दो which would be hardly like 10 odd people. अगर उनको या you know say 1000 odd people अगर उनको निकाल दो तो फिर सोचो कि हमारी economy में कितने ऐसे लोग हैं जिनकी income कितनी कम है as a result of which our income is only 1820 US dollars. And why is this happening? There are various reasons. India is a heavily populated country. This can go with us and this go against, this can go against us. When I say we are a heavily populated country, that means whenever the population increases, there is a scarcity. in our kind of culture, an average person becomes an adult at the age of 18, right? And then we still will live with our parents to the age of 22, 23, 24. Then we settle down and at the same time we try to do the same business which our parents are doing. We don't venture out. Whereas in other countries, what happens after the age of 16, people start earning. So their working population is more. In spite of the fact that their total population is less, their working population is more. And 15, 20 years before, half of our population was not working because most of the women were not working. They were housewives. Now of course, we are becoming a progressive economy, so that is why the number of housewives, I'm not saying housewives are not good. They are more managers, they are more creators. But as far as contribution to the economy is concerned, in a family, there is only one working hand. The economy, the economical growth stagnates. Right? So, obviously things are changing, but we still have a long way to go. First, from low income country, we have to become a high middle income country, and then we have to go ahead and become rich income group country. Facebook is not good. 10 minutes. So, this is where we really need to think. And again, you know, today still we have that system wherein we say that, okay, fine, education is not very important. In fact, education is the most important loser which is there with every boy or girl in the last breath that he takes. If he has nothing to do, at least he has the skill of surviving. So education, language, communication is very, very important. Right? So, we have understood today how World Bank classifies the various countries of the world and how UNDP classifies. Again, it's a debatable issue, that is income the only criteria for development. Middle East countries, they have loads of income because they have oil reserves. But now what is happening? Because of which they are now concentrating on education and skill development. Slowly, the oil reserves are finishing off. The economy is going into doldrums. And then they are fighting. Because it is becoming difficult in the oil, everybody wants to have the control of whatever very little is left of oil reserves instead of finding alternatives. Economy becomes stagnated when we don't have alternatives. The more and more alternatives we find, the more and more economy grows individually also at a micro level and at a micro level. Right? Now when we talk about development, this is where development and growth differs. So I personally feel that development is also about not only intellectual growth, qualitative enhancement or whatever, but development is also our ability to adapt to, at the same time, adapt to the environment, accept that we have a problem and then find the alternative solution to that problem. Now, we have understood UNDP and we have understood World Bank. Hum kehte hain mera Bharat mahaan. But the situation is not very good as far as our UNDP is concerned. That means as far as our Human Development Index is concerned. If you talk about Human Development Index, a rank was created amongst 177 countries of the world. Whereas India stands only at 132. Out of 132 out of 177 countries of the world. We are happy that Pakistan is below us, but we should feel a little bit of triggering effect in us that Sri Lanka is above us. Their lifestyle is much better than us. Their income standards are much better than us. Their literacy rate is better than us because we believe in education. The latest trend is that after doing your last year, many of us just think of going away from the country, leaving the country stranded. Humne sabne Canada jana hai. Now what happens is ki ab hum jab sab Canada ja rahe hain, to get that education, to get degree education outside, if you are not a resident of that country, is 3 times more. So then what we do is we do diploma. We don't even have their complete formal education. and then we expect to make more money out of it. It's a question to think that instead of going out and creating, becoming a source of development for some other country where you will always be a secondary citizen, why not think of development of your own country? Stay within your own country. India has the youngsters with a lot of brains. We adapt very easily to technology. We adapt very easily to the new culture. Right? So, obviously, UNEPS told us that we are way below as far as standard of living is concerned. Now, it is between you and me to decide that how we need to improve this standard. Right? And I think this is the reason why CBSE has introduced this particular chapter at this level, so that you realize your own potentials and you work towards the development of the country. Right? Now, we have done UNDP and we have done World Bank. We have seen their criteria in both the situations. India is not doing that well. If you see, if you relate to newspapers, our GDP has also fallen down. I'm talking about the issues before the coronavirus thing. We need to work it out. And this will happen only when you learn to trust your own country. Now, this was at a very macro level when we compared which country is doing where, what is the state of India and how we are doing. Now, let us understand that how, education leads to better lifestyle. If you look at the per capita income of Bihar in 2015-16, it was 164,034. That means every individual, sorry, it was Haryana. Every individual in Haryana would earn 162,034 rupees, right, annually. Whereas its infant mortality rate was as high as 33 per thousand. At the same time, there were 33 deaths of children below the age group of 1. And what could be the direct reason for that? We have as good as, the literacy rate is as low as 82% as compared to 94% in Kerala, whose infant mortality rate is just 10 children per thousand, because the awareness is better. In Haryana, there is honor killing, then there is infant killing, and then of course fetus killing, because of the fact that it's a patriarchal society over there. Then, if you look at the net attendance ratio, what is your net attendance ratio? That it means that between 14 to 15 years, your age group, after your age group, how many people are going ahead with more education? If you talk about Haryana, it has a literacy rate, matlab log likh aur padh sakte hain, 82 people out of 100 people. Padhna likhna aa gaya, hum munde hain, hamari achievement hogi, dharti pe aa gaye, humne achieve kar liya jo achieve karna tha. अब उसके बाद हमारा इस दुनिया में कुछ करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, हम चिल मानेंगे. दैट इज़ द रीज़न नेट अटेंडेंस रेशियो इज जस्ट 61%. दैट मीन्स आफ्टर अ सर्टन लेवल ऑफ एजुकेशन चिल्ड्रन फील दैट इट्स इनफ. हो गया, आपके में पढ़ना लिखना आ गया है. नाउ इट्स अ टाइम फॉर अस टू ईदर जॉइन आवर फैमिली बिजनेस और इट्स अ टाइम फॉर अस टू टेक आउट आवर बाइक्स एंड देन वी हैव टू मूव अवे. राइट? दैट इज वाई the situation is becoming more and more grim in these areas. The crime is at rise. If you look at Bihar, the Bihar literacy rate is lowest. It is just 62%. Whereas infant mortality rate is the highest. That is 38%. That means 38 per thousand children die because of ignorance, because people are uneducated in Bihar. Again, the crime rate in Bihar is way too high. And it is directly related to the literacy rate. Right? Now, net attendance ratio, only 43 per 100 students pursue higher education in Bihar. That means what? Approximately 57 out of every 100 students are sitting at home. And wo 43 bachcho mein se maximum administrative services mein nikal kar aate hain. Because these are those people who really want to study. Because Bihar mein again, the administrative services, there are more people who qualify IIT, there are more people who qualify administrative. administrative services. They are out of those 43 children. Baki 57 bachche to gay young hai, nonsense kar rahe, lad rahe, jhagad rahe, gang wars kar rahe. Right? So it's a story that we all need to, rather it's a viewpoint that we all need to really think about. That is income the only criteria for development? When you look at the statistics, you realize that income hai, phir bhi crime hai. Income hai, phir bhi bahut sare issues hai. So it is not just income. It is our mentality, and mentality has to be upgraded and updated, and that will happen only if we are educated. Right? So just leaving studies and going abroad and becoming a taxi driver is not what we want from our lives. Aim for becoming something big. Think of having your own startups. See, young boys, this Oyo child person is very young. He's just 23 years old, I think. And he is an owner worth crores, and he was not very good in studies or excellent or whatever it is. It is just that he aimed big in life. So thought process, always think a little ahead of times. Right? Stop. I shall see you tomorrow.